skip ahead. Maybe later he talks about Grandpa's thing.
Wait, there's some kind of a list. Could be a clue. Toys Colonel Gentleman wishes he had when he
was a lad, but they weren't invented yet. Micronauts. Scooby-Doo Monster Game? Witch-Witch. At-At Imperial Walker? Stay Alive, the Survival Game.
What is that code?
Colonel Gentleman's good names for an imaginary friend. Colonel Gentleman's Hollywood actresses who need a smack in the mouth. They go on and on. This is a crazy person's diary.
Hello, Internet. And if you're watching this the day it comes out, happy Halloween. My name is Billy, and this is your guide to the Ventureverse, a YouTube series in which I look at each episode of the Venture Brothers and give a brief synopsis, point out interesting facts, talk about its place in the greater canon of the show, and finish it off with some personal thoughts about the episode. In today's video, we will discuss Season 2, Episode 5 of The Venture Brothers, 20 Years to Midnight. This episode first aired on August 6th, 2006. Let's get into it. The Venture family finds a box containing a video message from Jonas Venture Sr. that tells them the fate of the world rests on them activating a device, the pieces of which have been scattered around the globe. Joining forces with JJ and Pirate Captain, the family splits up into smaller groups to find the pieces in time. Jackson and Doc talk a bit more about the relationship between Pirate Captain and JJ and what makes them the perfect two characters to team up.
And we wanted their whole life to be about two guys buddying up and filling each other in on everything they lost. Because Pirate Captain was stuck at sea for like 15 years or something, and Jonas was
stuck in an abdomen.
Yeah.
Fun fact, as pointed out in the commentary track, the background for New York City, as seen from Impossible Tower, was recycled from the Tokyo background created for the pilot. Doc references writing a letter to the Herculoids. Herculoids was a TV show from the same era as Johnny Quest, but it's apparently real life in the Venture Brothers. This episode features the return of Pirate Captain, who made his debut in Ghosts of the Sargasso.
Sit on my lap, son. It's story time.
I don't want to sit in your lap.
Fine, don't.
This episode also features Johnny Quest. He'll later come to be known as Action Johnny because the powers that be didn't want the Venture Brothers to use Johnny Quest anymore. But for now, take it as fact that, according to the credits, this is the actual Johnny Quest, aged up and strung out. We get the sort of return of original Team Venture member Colonel Gentleman, though he is presumed dead. The Impossible Building, where much of the latter part of this episode takes place, was briefly mentioned by Sally Impossible back in Ice Station Impossible.
My brother Cody was in town. I was giving him and my mentally handicapped cousin Ned a tour of the Impossible Building in New York, and there was this explosion.
I remember when that happened!
Regarding the Impossible Building, it's touched upon that Venture Industries used to occupy the space where Impossible Tower now stands. Jackson says in the art book, another thing that got cut down is the idea that the Impossible Tower was built on the location of the former Venture New York headquarters, which would have looked like the Pan Am Building. Professor Impossible finds a piece of the invention in the foundation, but the whole backstory of when and how Impossible Tower ended up there, a lot of that got cut. Enough time has passed since Ice Station Impossible that Sally has gone from just finding out she's pregnant to actually having a son, Rocket. Near the end of the episode, we get a hint at the budding relationship between JJ and Sally Impossible. This episode feels like it could easily be turned into a movie. It's a pretty big, sprawling, globe-trotting adventure that culminates in a big final act that sees everyone teamed up again for a final showdown with the big bad. In fact, I don't hear anyone talking about it these days, but back when Iron Man 2 came out in theaters, there were lots of people online pointing out the similarities to this episode. In Iron Man 2, Tony Stark gets a video message from his dead father, and in a race against time has to recreate one of his father's old inventions. Jackson and Doc seem to really like characters that speak in a stilted, robotic way, and the Grand Galactic Inquisitor is kind of the first time we see that. Ignore Me is funny enough on its own, but pretty much everything he says is hilarious. I find myself constantly thinking about
someone left a baby!
And
that was a weird one!
When I'm just going about my daily life. I'm kind of glad he was killed at the end of the episode so that he can always live on as a fond memory. Because I love the Grand Galactic Inquisitor, and I love the Venture Brothers. As always, thank you for watching and go Team Venture. Tune in next week for Victor Echo November. If you dug this video, share it with a friend. And if there was some huge thing that I missed in this video, Follow me on Instagram at VentureverseGuide to see these videos early and offer your input before I upload the final product.